but we are going to celebrate yet another time the Krishna Jayanti with all of you because Krishna wanted a separate play date with all of you today. Okay, so we are here to experience that bliss. Kiranji, who is the chief priest of this temple, is here to welcome all of you and share some thoughts. You saw the Naivedyam, the food we offered, we saw the Aarti. If you have any questions, you can ask Kiranji. And Kiranji is also here to share some childhood stories of this. Okay, thank you so much for the support to the Bharat Heritage Organization.
Welcome to SVK Temple. Say Namaste.
Namaste.
So, Bharatiya Heritage. So, today we are starting the Yatra tour, temple tours. So, questions, why we have to come to temple? God is everywhere, right? So, why we have to come to the temple? So, a lot of kids have asked the question. So obviously, yes, God is everywhere, but why in the temple everywhere everybody is coming and gathering and do the prayer? So simple question is that everywhere is God, but is in the temple have more powerful. Example I will explain. So example like bank manager, you can see the bank manager, right? So we are going for collecting all funds and keeping the money in the bank, right? So you can go to temple, sorry, you can go to bank, you can cash the money, right? Withdraw the money. So money is your money, bank manager is there, bank is there. So if your bank manager has found some in the Walmart store or price store, if you go and can you ask him, the same manager is there, right? In the Walmart or price. You can ask them, can I get my money? So can he give money? No, right? But you have to go to a certain place, some certain procedure, then only you will get your money. So you are coming to temple, not asking your things, right? So you are getting the blessings. So then you have to go to a certain place and certain procedure you have to do, like puja, arati, prayers, everything you have to do. Then only get the blessing. This is all the procedure to pray Lord, okay? This is a simple answer. I'm explaining the thing why we have to go to the temple like that. So everywhere we pray together, then get more energy. So why we have to do the Murti Puja? Like statue, right? So we can see the statue. The statue is the God. No, statue is not a God. We are seeing the God through statue. Murti Puja, like we are seeing the Murti, God in the vigrahas or statues. So in the, we do the arati, we do the naivedyam, we do the decorating the Murti. Why we have to do everything? So some people asking, so wasting the money, wasting the flowers, wasting the fruits. Not at all. That is not a wrong. That's a wrong thing. So when we do decorating the things, we are getting God. How we can see the God? So we can meditate. So like that, we do arati, naivedyam. Whatever we give, so we have to offer God, then only we will take the prasadam, as a prasadam, fruits, whatever food, everything we have to offer first, then we have to take the prasadam, as a prasadam. Without do naivedyam, we should not take, because that is not our thing, right? Everything is God given, so we have to offer Him and we have to take it, right? So that is called a prasadam. So before that, you do Shodasha Upachara Puja. So we have to do Arghya, Arghya, everything. So welcoming God, washing feet, and giving the Arghya Achamanam, giving the Snanam, do Alankara. Then we do Dupa, Deepa. Like Dupa means we show the Dupa, the what is it? Agarubhati. Agarubhati is not a Dupa. So Agarubhati is getting, Dupa is actually this Dupa, Dupa. Different
Samrayam.
That is a Dupa. So according to Shastra, Agarubhati is not a Dupa. Agarubhati, Agaru means good smell. Bhatti means stick. That's all. That we should not throw, because now these days they are adding the all the chemicals, everything. So that is not called a Dupa. But now these days we are without, we don't, it's very difficult to find the Amrani. So we are using that Agarubhati. Agarubhati, Agaru means good smell. Ogaru means bad smell. Agarubhati, Ogaru means bad smell. Agaru means good smell. So we'll get the good vibration, good thinking. If you have good, see, if you have bad smell, we cannot concentrate with anything. So if you have good smell, so we can concentrate to God, Lord. So that's why Agarubhati is there. So you, basically we have to show the Samrani, then Deepa, then Nevedyam, then Arati. So a lot of, of course, a lot of time I told why we have to, how we have to do Arati. Why we have to do Arati, how to take the Arati. This is all the Dharma Sukshma Vishaya. So when we do the Arati, we are showing the Arati first, three times in the Pada, then three times in the Nadi, then three times in the face, Mukha. Then again Pada, Apada, Bhumi. So we have to three times again Pada to head. Three times we have to show. That's all, so that 12 times, three, three, three. And again three times in the Apada, Bhumi. So we had, this is the Arati, 12 times we had to do three Pada in the first place, and three is the Nadi in the other place. The three in the face. So we are showing the Arati like this, and we are seeing the God face in the Deepa, like. What is the Shastra saying? When we do the Arati, we will get the energy from the God. Why we have to do the Arati in the fire? Right? There are simple questions. So we can do in anything, Dupa also we can do Arati. Why we have to do the Arati with the fire? In the Shastra said, Veda says, Agnihi Shuchihi Vipradamaha, Shuchihi Vipraha, Shuchihi Kravihi. In the world, Agni is the pure. Nobody can do what Malini, what is called Malini? Yeah. Yeah, correct. The fire, right? So if you add something for the water will correct. If something add to the air will correct. But fire, nobody can correct the fire. Fire is the pure. Agni hi shuti hi. Shuti hi vipradamaha, shuti hi vipraha, shuti hi kavihi. So Agni is the first pure. So we have whatever good things we have to offer to God. So when we do the Arati, so we have to see his face. That means we will get the energy from the God through fire. So again, we are, of course, everybody saying, both hands we have to use and we have to take the Arati. But according to Shastra, we have to use only one hand taking the Arati. Very difficult to switch both hands to one hand, but try to do that. So we have to take one hand using the Arati, taking one time, taking from Arati to the energy to heal, the purifying the body. Second one we are taking again and purifying the knowledge in the Jnana Chakram here. So purifying the knowledge. Third time we have to take and put it here, purifying the Atma, Atma Shuddhi. So this is the way to take the Arati, the Anusandhana, the thinking, you're getting the energy from the God and taking the energy to our body, our knowledge, our Atma. So this is the way to take the Arati, trying to do both hands to one hand. It's not easy, because from childhood we are using the both hands. So according to Shastra, in the Varaha Purana it says like that, Arathya Grahane Kali Eka Hastena Yojayese Yadi Hastadvayena Iva Mama Drohina Samshayaha. When you take the Arati, you have to use one hand. If you use both hands, Mama Drohi, so making the Droham for me, is the Varaha Swami is saying that. So trying to switch one hand, both hands to one hand. So this is the way to take the arpana. And after that, whatever we do, all the pujas, and we have to do the krishna arpana. So yad karoshi yadashnasi yad juhosi tadasi yad tapasyasi kaunteya tat purushvam adarpanam. Shri Krishna said, yad karoshi, whatever you do in whole day, yad juhosi, whatever you offer, yad tadati, whatever you give, yad karoshi yadashnasi, whatever you eat, whatever you do tapas, whatever you do prayer, whatever you do meditation, you have to offer me. So I will give you according to your yoga. So whatever we do, good things, whatever everything we have to offer Lord Krishna. So Krishna will give the prasadam, whatever our yoga. So same thing. So if you say this, I can say. So kids, the baby crying, keep crying, right? So if a baby go to some other person, they don't know why the baby is crying. So they can give whatever they want. Baby is ill and is some upset or again crying. So the crying is not stopped. But if baby go to the mother know why baby is crying. How much they can for baby need that, how much we have to give the baby. So the mother can give our yoga. They know that how much baby can give, how much baby can do her jirna. So everything that the baby, the mother know that. So for mother, for us is love. So whatever we do, all the karmas, we have to offer Krishna. Krishna will give whatever our yoga, our capacity. He will give you, give us, God will give us. So that's why the give that. So whatever we do, we have to do the Krishna arpanam in front of the anyone, any puja. So this is the way to do the puja. And why we have to, I'm sure maybe why you have to, you understand why you have to come to the temple. So then after that, coming to my life. So in childhood, I am very interested to the puja. So of course, my father is bank manager, my mother is housewife. So different work my father and mother do. So I come from childhood, I am very interested to the puja, decoration and decoration, everything we do. So my father decided to do the, he said, can you go to Gurukula? I said yes, because I want to go to Gurukula and I want to become a priest from the childhood.
We all know what is a Gurukula?
Gurukula means education, religious education. So we have to go there, we have to stay there. So we are not coming to the house. Coming to maybe like two months, three months, only two to three days only. Then Gurukula system is different than you imagine. So morning, 4 o'clock, we have to get up. No, in the first thing we have to do Suprabhat. I'm sure everybody knows Suprabhata. So Suprabhata we have to do 4 o'clock to 4:30 p.m. And after that we have every student have gave him one cow. We have on the Udupi, we have Goshala, the cow. So every student have one cow responsibility. So we have to do Goshala every day half an hour. And after that we have 1 hour, we have to do yoga asana meditation until 6 o'clock. This is the everyday routine. 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock. Then 6 o'clock, no bathroom. We have to take shower in the river. In the rain, we have to go and take shower in the river. No bathroom at all in the Gurukula. So again, 6 to 6:30, half an hour, we have Gurukula also, take shower, everything. Then 6:30 to 8 o'clock, Sandhya Vandana and the meditation, puja. This is all our routine, 8 o'clock. And 8 to 8:30 break for the day, 8 to 8:30 we are getting the breakfast. Then 8:30 to 9 o'clock we have some break. 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock, 3 batches clock, 1 hour. So again 12 to 12:30 we have Madhyanika Sandhyavandana. Again we have to do Sandhyavandana, the prayer. And again 12:30 to 2 o'clock we have lunch. and like nap, we can take like half an hour nap, or we can do revisions, practice we can do. Again 2 to 5, again 3 hours, every 1 hour of classes. All Vedas, Vyakarana, Shastra, Stotra, all the classes. And 5 to 6, 1 hour break, that is our best time. 5 to 6 is playing time, play time. So again 6 to 7 Sandhyavandana, 7 to 8 bhajans. Every day 1 hour bhajan, 1 hour Sandhyavandana and Parayana prayers. Then 8 to 8:30 dinner and 8:30 to 10 o'clock revisions, practice all the time. Then 10 o'clock everybody should sleep. So this is the routine of Gurukula. So this is like this 6 years we went. Of some Gurukula I have 12 years, but I went for 6 years. In that, in between I did Sanskrit MBA and other courses also. Then after 6 years, Swamiji will select some students. In the way, usually we have 20-30 students. We have some branches in India, some branches in US. That time in 2001, so 2000 we opened the temple in Arizona. He select 2 priests, one myself and one of his other priest in New Jersey. So he brought us here for 6 months and he said we're just visiting the temple, so we can just visit and see. Then after we came here and Swamiji said you stay here. So that's all, we came with visa, we stay here. And then that time is the visa process is 8 years I never got in here. So I stuck in 8 years in US. So then after doing all the seva, all the Swamiji seva, everything. So in other than, and this is my history, and since 2001 to 2020 years. And then of course the temple came, this, all the miracles happened. In the 2000 we Swamiji opened the temple here in the small house, and he bought the Vigraha. You can see the Uttamamurti, 150 years old Uttamamurti from the Sri Rangam. So we got the Vigraha from Uttamamurti from the Sri Rangam. And 150 years old, in that time now 170 years. So we did the puja 10 years in the Chandler in our house. After that we found this property, we came here. In 2010 we came here, in April we got an email saying that we have one Vigraha, so anybody wants to take that Vigraha. They're supposed to, this Mulavrat, supposed to go to New York temple, Satyadharana temple, New York. And some issue they said rejected, then already shipped from the Tirupati. So on the way, they sent the email. So I said, I don't know why I have to reply yes. So they called me, I said, okay, you want to take a Vigraha. Why I don't know, because we didn't prepare anything. But we said yes. I said yes, because after that I called Swamiji, I said yes. And Swamiji said, okay, we'll see the Vigraha. So if you have good Lakshana, everything we can use in the temple. So then in the December, we got the, that's all, after that no contact or anything. I don't know who, then October, December month, they called me from the New York. So Vigraha is already in the Phoenix. So delivery, Friday they called me, Saturday they are going to deliver the Vigraha. So we didn't prepare anything. Then after that, so Saturday morning we finished the Abhisheka and Lord is, Venkateshwara is here. So we kept inside. After that we think, so we cannot do Vigraha only Venkateshwara. We have to do other Vigrahas, Lakshmi also has to come. I don't know, because the already is January, December, January. The June is the Dakshinayana. The Vigraha process is long. So we have to order the Vigraha. Then I found the Google and called Stapati in one number, got number and called Stapati. He said, Kiranji, so you have the procedure here. You have to come and do the Muhurtam and Vigraha Murta. So then only we had to perform the Vigrahas. We have some procedure for that. So I said, Venkateshwara is here, we don't know, he came himself, which is not our thing. So he came himself, so we have to do something. So can you help? So he said, give me 2-3 days. Then after that, he called me. So Kiranji, so we do one thing. So 2012, the Sydney have done some temple. So we did the muhurtam, everything we karo, the vigraha, everything is ready. So we have enough time for them to make the vigraha. So I am going to send the vigraha. So Lakshmi, Ganesha, Shiva, everything they are supposed to go to Sikri temple. So they came there. So everything is there, is not in our hands. We didn't do anything. So they want, they came. This is a lot of miracles happen. Now after we and also. So when we do the Pratishtha, we do the Arani Mathana. So Arani, we tried, previous day we try get the fire. So you know, right, Arani mean like we are not natural fire. We are just do the good things and both two kind of foods and get the fire.
You previous, the wood you have to keep scrubbing and then fire.
You get the fire.
Yeah.
So previous day we did in 5 minutes and next day we tried 45 to 50 minutes. We are nervous. So we don't know what we have to do. What happened is we close this door because actually when we do the build the vigraha, garbhagraha, so we cannot, after building the vigraha, we cannot keep the vigraha inside. So whatever we did, we cover the vigraha, we did the, keep it the vigraha and build the vigraha things. And we close the door and doing, trying to get the fire. Didn't happen. Then the Swamiji said, can you open the door and do the right things. So we just opened the door, within 1 minute we got the vigraha. This is all the, his miracle. So we saw in our hand. We saw with that miracles. So this has happened in our temple, a lot of miracles happen and he's here, he is blessing us, you know. So if you have any questions,
the
Vishnupada, we said Vishnupada, Sri Vaishnava says Amandam Pada. So we are blessing, basically blessing us. So in the Shalikrama is the Vishnu Shalikrama, especially the olden days, we'll get the Shalikrama from Gandaki River in Nepal. So maybe I can show the Shalikrama. All natural.
Not yeah. Curved.
This is not curved from human.
All natural.
So yeah, what is called the creamy is called the incense curve. This Sudarshana.
Sudarshana
chakra. Yeah, the both you can see both. Some other Shaligramas have multi Sudarshanas. So in this one only two Sudarshanas. So you can see Sudarshana.
It's naturally formed.
Yeah.
Not man-made. Yeah. You'll get it from Nepal. Nepal country. They have Gandaki River, particular Gandaki River. In there we'll get this one. In the Shaligrama have behind big story. So I don't have much time to explain the thing. Yeah. So we have a lot of Shaligramas and every Shaligrama have different akara. So
which you see and Mahavishnu, Krishna, everybody. So that also we are going to have. The significance of this is the white two lines represents the Vishnu Padam, the Tiruvadi of Mahavishnu, the holy feet of Mahavishnu. And the Sri Churnam, the red, and some people wear it in yellow, that represents Mahalakshmi. So Mahavishnu together with Mahalakshmi protects us, and that's our right, and we keep both of them on our head. So let's get started.
Thank you.
of yet, it's being explained by science. We are still discovering many things. They are not inventing, they are discovering. Yeah. They are there already and they are uncovering it.
Yeah. And another thing is about the science. We had planes when everyone else would stone would play.
Yes, we have documentary about like Ramayana talks about Pushpaka Vimana. But due to a lot of the invasions that happened, many of our ancient texts have been stolen or destroyed. So maybe someday we will get back those things. So
now everybody believes in us of atheists.
Okay. Yes, you are touching God's feet and you are touching Bhuma Devi, you know, the Lord, one of the Mahavishnu's concept that we call is basically, she is full of patience. That's the main quality of Bhuma Devi. No matter how much you have to so many drugs, cars, we run around, jump, she, and we abuse her to the maximum, but yet she is patient, she is very patient. So that's the quality, God is very patient with us. So that's the quality that Bhuma Devi says, and when we touch her and do this, we are trying to remember that quality and imbibe some of it on us. It reminds us to be patient with everything that happens in our life. And of course, it reminds us that we are surrounded with it.
Does polluting the earth make Mother Earth sick?
Should it? In fact, that is the beauty of Sanatana Dharma, that we treated everything as God so that we won't misuse the natural resources. We don't abuse it. That was the way of life before all the invasions came. I was reading yesterday about sustainability. They said it's a modern concept. I just chuckled. It's not a modern concept. It's an ancient wisdom which we, Sanatana Dharma Hinduism, had. They talk about social, economic, and environment. All of these factors should be considered in any decisions we make in our lives, be it personal or corporate, or governmental decisions. But that's how our ancient system was there. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha.